Originating from the rocky grasslands of Afghanistan, Pakistan, Iran, and northwest India, Euphorbius macularis, more commonly known as a leopard gecko, is a small ground-dwelling gecko known for its distinctive fat tail and movable eyelids. It is not completely clear who first discovered leopard geckos, but it is thought to have happened in the 1800s. Since then, leopard geckos have been selectively bred in the pet trade for their colours and patterns. This selective breeding has led to a variety of leopard gecko morphs becoming readily available to the public. However, some, like the Enigma morph, has proven to be somewhat problematic in some individuals who inherit Enigma syndrome. Due to the political climate in the regions where leopard geckos are from, as well as their shy nature and crepuscular habits, almost nothing is known about their natural behaviour. However, from watching our pet geckos and a large amount of trial and error, herpetology enthusiasts have come pretty close to figuring out the best husbandry practices for our scaly friends, though the reptile hobby is always evolving and we should be prepared to evolve with it. Despite varying colours and patterns, every leopard gecko requires the same basic care. A 20-gallon tank should be sufficient for a leopard gecko. Though they aren't natural climbers, they do enjoy exploring vertical obstacles in their enclosure as part of their physical enrichment and natural curiosity. To heat their tank, they require a heat mat. The heat mat should cover 30 to 50% of the terrarium floor space, and its job is to keep the leopard gecko's hotspot nice and warm at around 30 to 34 degrees Celsius. A thermostat should be used to control the temperature of the heat mat, ensuring it doesn't get too hot or too cold. There should be at least 2 to 3 hides in a leopard gecko's tank, as they love to hide. They could, and often do, spend all day in a cozy, warm, dark hide. They need one hide on their hotspot, one on the cold end of the tank, and one in the middle that has moss, substrate, or a damp paper towel in that will act as a humid hide. Substrate is a highly debated topic with leopard geckos. A common misconception is they must be housed on sand, as some documents suggest they live in a desert environment and most people assume it's sandy. However, their natural environment isn't sandy at all. In fact, they live in rocky grasslands. Substrates such as Kelsey sand, once ingested, can cause health problems such as blockages in the digestive system, known as impaction. The most highly recommended substrates for geckos over 6 months old are EcoEarth, bioactive substrates such as Arcadia's Earth Mix Arid, tiles, or paper towel. A UV light can also be added to a leopard gecko setup, as UVA and UVB can both be beneficial to a gecko's health and lessen the risk of metabolic bone disease, as long as a UV light is used alongside the correct supplements. In order to administer the supplements, they should be dusted on the gecko's food. Speaking of food, let's talk about diet. Leopard geckos are primarily insectivores, which means they eat insects. The best insects for your leopard gecko staple diet are dubia roaches, crickets, locusts, mealworms, or calci worms. Insects such as superworms and waxworms can be fed occasionally, but they're often considered to be more like treats for the leopard gecko. It is important to remember that happy, well-fed insects will be much more nutritious than malnourished, sickly ones. You should always gut load your feeders with a range of vegetable scraps. As previously mentioned, they should also be dusted with the appropriate calcium and vitamin mix before being fed to your gecko. To learn more, check out this video. Leopard geckos make great pets, and when given the correct care, they can live for 20 years or more. Unfortunately, a lot of websites and care sheets have outdated information, often encouraging the use of calci sand or downplaying the importance of using supplements. Two common practices that carry a lot of risk. So here's to improving the standard of care for our scaly friends.